Comedy aside, America's emergency room saw more than 120,000 related injuries between 2002 and 2012, and that's according to the estimates. That's something former Silicon Valley executive Dolly Singh understands very well. She created Thesis Couture with a mission to redesign the high heel into something more comfortable. Dolly, good morning.
Good morning.
And bless you, my child. So this is the thing. This came out of personal frustration for you, yes?
Yeah, absolutely. You know, I'm a working professional. I worked in a very large campus. It was an industrial space, so it's a lot of hard floors. I was walking 3 to 4 miles a day in the factory every day. And so this was a personal frustration, and I figured it was time to solve it.
And you solved it by doing what? Or you think you're solving it by doing
what?
Well,
I'm trying to solve it by, so my background is recruiting. I've been able to put together some really talented engineering teams in the past. And so what I decided to do was use those talents to put together a really diverse group of people to try to attack the problem in a way that it hasn't been approached before.
So you have a former NASA astronaut, a rocket scientist, an orthopedic surgeon. What do they know about high heels?
Yeah, they don't know much about high heels, but they know a lot about engineering. They know a lot about the human body. And it was really about redefining the problem. So we talked to our engineers about building it like the world's smallest chassis or like a tiny little bridge that fits inside of a high heel, not them being focused on the fact that it's a high heel.
And so when you had all those engineers unpack a normal high heel, what did you discover?
Yeah, that was one of the first things that I discovered is that inside your high heels, you're basically standing on a very thin metal plate. So there's no structure. So it doesn't take an engineer or a rocket scientist or an astronaut to figure out that you can probably do better than this.
And so what are you switching that out
and
for?
And so what we're doing is using an advanced polymer, which is sort of a ballistic grade plastic, and that is precision formed, and it changes the amount, the way that the structure loads. You basically want to provide more surface area and match it to the geometry of the underside of the foot more effectively, because that's what's going to change the way the load distributes. So in most cases, when you're on one of these, 80% of your weight is at your toes. Our structure brings it down to 50%.
So what's the experience like now for people who've tried the prototype or the product?
The way that I like to describe it is we're basically trying to create a stiletto that feels and functions like a wedge. So most women that have stood on this will agree that the lateral stability is much better and it feels like you're standing on a wedge and not like a classic stiletto.
Well, listen, we want function, but I'll show you this. This is one of my shoes. It's Christian Louboutin. I think
yes.
It's a work of art.
It's beautiful.
I really do. But by the end of the day, I am hobbling. Nobody looks good when they're hobbling. He makes no apologies. He said, it's uncomfortable. I don't want anybody to think it's uncomfortable. So can you make something this pretty, this gorgeous, but still be comfortable? People say they can do it, Dolly. I haven't seen it.
Yeah, well, that's our goal. We just hired our first guest designer. His name is Nick LaRusso. He spent the last 7 years as the director of design for women's shoes at Jimmy Choo. So he is also obsessed with sexy shoes.
Yeah.
So that's our job, is to really try to walk that line and thread the needle better than anybody else has before. So if you look at these pieces, they don't look orthopedic, right? So our job is to tighten that envelope even more over the next few months and get to finished pieces that look pretty close to that. It won't be this skinny though. Mm-hmm. So one of the big differences is that this is much wider. Mm-hmm. And it's skinny across the side, which is the more important perspective, but wider across the back, because that lateral stability is what causes a lot of the ankle injuries that women have.
So, Dolly, everybody wants to know quickly cost and when will they be available?
Our collections will be priced between $350 to $950.
That's debut. Expensive. Stop. $950,
yes.
That's high.
I think that is $350 to $950 is the classic American luxury bracket. So our day style will be at about $350. Our red carpet looks will be closer to $900.
And when will they be available?
This fall, we'll open our first reservation list for our debut edition, and there'll be 1,500 units, all numbered and signed by our astronaut and our guest designer.
This is all online.
This will be all on our website. That's correct.
I would be happy to test them for you.
Yeah, absolutely. I'll make sure we get you a pair.
Size 10, 10 and a half.
Size 8 and a half.
Yeah, the 8 is easy, yes. 8 will come first, 10 will come second.
8 is easy. Okay.
Well, all of our R&D with footwear, you have to repeat R&D with each size a little bit.
I get it. I get it. I got big feet, I know. But I wish you luck. This is very exciting.
Thank you so much. I really appreciate it. Thanks for having me, guys.
Thank you, Dolly.